Hi guys, EJ here, back to do another update, and today for July 7th, 2011, 10 new movies to show you, all from the 80s, some are awesome, obviously, 80s awesomeness, and some are a little more obscure than the most, but 10 new movies, so let's get on with it. So up first we have Always, a Steven Spielberg film from 1989, starring Richard Dreyfuss, Holly Hunter, and John Goodman. A good drama about pilots who fight fires, and very emotional film, really good performances by all three of these people. Film I haven't seen in a long time actually, but I've seen it on TV a few years back, but a good film. Up next is, of course, Beverly Hills Cop from 1984. Love the original. I was going to get the sequels, but I'm holding off on that. I didn't want to get like the three pack, the three disc case, but of course, Eddie Murphy, great, is Axel Foley. Detroit cop who goes to LA to find the killer of his best friend. Judge Reinhold and John Ashton are great as the Beverly Hills detectives who help him. Just a great fun film directed by Martin Brest. Loved the first one, the second one's pretty good, and the third one's just kind of okay. But yeah, definitely like the first one. Okay, up next we've got Dirty Rotten Scoundrels from 1988, starring Steve Martin and Michael Caine as con men sort of living it up on the French Riviera. Hilarious, very funny movie. Steve Martin, great as usual, as is Michael Caine in this. Now a film that a couple of people will be interested in. And that is, of course, our own J.A. who appears to have returned to YouTube this past week. I know she's a big fan of this, as is her good friend Justin, Ryan, 1988. And that is, of course, the classic Fright Night vampire film from 1985 with Chris Sarandon, Roddy McDowall, and Amanda Bearse. I always got kind of cracked up when I saw Amanda Bearse in this film, having just known her from Married with Children all those years. I don't know much of her other film work, but I always remember her in this. And they're, of course, doing a remake with Colin Farrell and who's the kid in it? Anton Yelchin, I believe his name is. Yeah, it looks pretty interesting. I'm not sure it'll be nearly as good as this, but great film, of course. Fright Night. Okay, up next we've got Moonstruck. Great film from 1987, starring Cher and Nick Cage. I believe it's a Norman Jewison film. Cher won an Oscar for Best Actress for this performance. About a divorcee who's looking to get remarried and falls in love with Nick Cage's character. Olympia Dukakis also won Best Supporting Actress for this film. Very good performances. Not a huge fan of Cher, but in the 80s she made a few good films. And she's actually appearing in another movie I bought this week. Up next we have Raising Arizona. Awesome Coen Brothers film from 1987. Starring Nick Cage and Holly Hunter. Just a crazy comedy. Every time I've seen this, it's just whacked out, this film about this couple. One's a small-time thief, marries a cop, and they steal a baby because they want a baby, and it's pretty crazy. It's kind of like Mad Max meets the Coen brothers. Just awesome. Okay, up next we have Salvador, and it's directed by Oliver Stone. I believe it came out in 86. I think it's 86. Yeah. 85 or 86. Great film starring James Woods as a photojournalist in El Salvador during the Civil War in the 80s. Also stars Jim Belushi. James Woods is really good in this film. One of the few Oliver Stone films I did not have in my collection. I think this and U-Turn are the only... is the only one I don't have, because I pretty much have all of Oliver Stone's films. I'm a big fan of his, one of my favorite directors. But I didn't like U-Turn, so I won't be getting that. It's an okay film, but Salvador, really good. James Woods, excellent. Kind of like The Killing Fields, sort of in that vein. War journalism type of stuff. Okay, up next we have Silkwood from 1984. Starring Meryl Streep, Kurt Russell, and again Cher. About three friends working at a Oklahoma nuclear power plant, and Meryl Streep's character becomes sick, and she starts to fight the system, fight the corporate office, working conditions and so on, about radiation, that kind of stuff. Great performance by Meryl Streep. She was nominated for the Academy Award for this film. So quick. Next is a film that also I know Peter, Matai of the Dead, is a huge fan of this film. I believe he said it was his favorite. Don't quote me on that, Peter, if I'm wrong, but I believe it was one of your favorites, if not the favorite. And that is To Live and Die in L.A. From 1985, directed by William Friedkin, who of course directed The French Connection, which is one of my all-time favorite films, and this is a great movie too, starring William Peterson as a federal agent, trying to track down William Dafoe, who's a counterfeiter by any means necessary. Just a great film. I'm a huge William Peterson fan, obviously from CSI. I love that show, I love his character. I also need to get Manhunter, another film of course made in the 80s. About, that was the Red Dragon, you know, Hannibal Lecter story. He's in that, great in that as well. But To Live and Die in L.A. And last but not least, is The War of the Roses. Awesome film from 1989 starring Michael Douglas and Kathleen Turner. And Danny DeVito, who also directed this film. Hilarious dark comedy about a seemingly very happy married couple who become divorced and pretty much fight over everything. Michael Douglas and Kathleen Turner, great in other 80s films, the Romancing the Stone and The Jewel of the Nile. This isn't really related to those films, but when you think of those other two, this always comes to mind when you talk about those films from the 80s. Just awesome, very funny film. All three are great, as usual. So those are my 10 pickups, 10 80s movies. 80s awesomeness right there. I wanted to play a song at the beginning of this, the theme from Beverly Hills Cop. You know the one I'm talking about. It was on the Scream soundtrack, but somehow it's not letting me buy it. My iTunes, the connection keeps timing out. It won't let me buy it. I thought it'd be perfect for this update, but I can't seem to get it. So. Hence you get these other songs. So thank you for watching, and until next time, I'll see you.